This old caravan where Richard and Sophie are living, you know, this is the exact opposite of what Richard's trying to build here. This place is really badly insulated, it leaks heat, and it leaks air as well. Whereas what Richard is doing is building a passive house. A passive house is so well insulated that it only needs the heat of the sun and human beings to warm it. It's completely airtight, and it uses a brilliant piece of technology that extracts all the heat from the stale air and recycles it within the building, which is brilliant. I mean, as to current building regulations, a passive house laughs in the face of those.
To reach the super eco standards of a passive house, Richard and Sophie have ordered some super expensive airtight triple-glazed windows.
48, 49, 49 units, 49 sections.
They'll insulate the house more efficiently than a brick wall. But no one makes triple glazed windows in England, so these have had to be imported from Austria.
Do you want to jam a bit of foam on the end of that? That's actually, as a point moment in time, more nervous than having a baby. And you see this big panel of glass, all it's got to do is hit something funny and that's it, gone.
That is nice. Even Sophie's weedy arms can open this.
12 out of 10 today, in terms of excitement value. Has to be a 12.
With so much glass, there's a risk of the house overheating in summer, but Richard's found a solution for that too.
This is a special window because it's triple glazed, but you've got one layer of glass here.
Yeah.
And then this section opens to open up the cavity because there's a blind in here.
Oh, blimey. Right, so that you've got a sun blind in there, which actually then ends up reflecting back a lot of the heat, even before it gets to the double glazing.
Yeah, so if you pull that...
Yeah, this thing here. Oh, wow, yeah! But these must be expensive.
Yeah, they were a very expensive part of the build.
But how much to do the house with this?
£43,000 is what we spent on windows.
The primary objective of a passive house is to reduce heat loss. So Richard's next big challenge is to make the timber frame draft-proof and airtight.
I'm making a technical model of the average Beano Homes timber-framed house, which, like the average timber-framed house, flexes and moves and is very leaky and has got lots of gaps around doors and windows. And it even has, as you can see here, these little trickle vents at the top of the windows to allow air into the building, which is not how Richard is going to build this. He's going to make an airtight house, a passive house. And in order to do that, he takes his timber frame and he then wraps it in an airtight fabric, which is going to completely seal this house.
A year into Richard and Sophie Hawke's experimental eco-build, disaster has struck. A large section of the tile arch has collapsed and the site is immediately shut. It's not until the end of the day that I'm allowed into the building to find a gaping hole in the roof.
Well, when it first happened, I have to say, the blood just drains out of your body. It's just, oh my goodness. But my first concern was, make sure everyone's all right. The rest of the structure is absolutely fine, but where it's single layer, it's got no strength at all. And
so
it just took somebody leaning on
it. Yeah, just leaning on it, yeah. Just woof, went underneath him.
Yeah.
Bit like when you perversely tried to put your foot, your left foot, on that arch that we made, and I thought, what's he doing? He knows it's... But you, for some reason, I think you just felt that it was going to support your weight.
Well, it's a kind of, I don't know, misplaced confidence.
Lucky escape. Really.
It was,
As Richard said, you know, this could have been a whole lot worse. But it has to be said that when you are building at the very edges of knowledge, you know, when you're building stuff which is at the boundaries of design and engineering, then this kind of thing, I'm afraid, just does occasionally happen. When you're doing stuff that nobody's done before, there is no manual.
A second winter is looming. but the collapsed roof suggests that the house is unlikely to be finished by Christmas.
At the moment, I go in there and can't quite imagine how that's going to happen, because although it's got so much further, it's still quite a long way to go, and I can't imagine that, you know, that's 6 weeks away, so... Yeah, last year it got really cold, January, February. I don't fancy going through that again.
As the team rebuild the arch, Richard starts to insulate his timber frame to the high standards of a passive house.
One of the crucial parts of the airtightness of the building is the insulation. And we've got a foot of it. It's 300 millimetres of it being pumped in through lots of holes, turning the building into Swiss cheese at the moment, pump it full of recycled newspaper.
There's all sorts of different colours in here.
I wonder what porn content the insulation of our house is. For example, or Hello magazines.
As well as the newspaper, Richard's also using sheep's wool to insulate internal walls for sound.
It's a fairly open plan house. You don't really want to hear too much what's going on when our guests are getting jiggy with it.
Even the doors have three airtight seals around the edges to keep the heat in. Of course, with an airtight house, there has to be some way of getting fresh air into the building. Otherwise, Richard and his family would suffocate.
Having insulated the building with your hemp and sheep's wool and your recycled newspaper, you've got to manage the ventilation as well, haven't you?
Well, a fundamental principle in an airtight passive house is to have heat recovery ventilation.
So is that what this is here? This is
This one here is taking the hot, smelly air, if you like, out of the bathroom here and all the other bathrooms, and that goes down to the heat recovery unit, which is in the utility room, where the heat is recovered into fresh air, and then that's passed through this duct, which is then it's got vents out into the
bedroom. You can have extractors throughout the building, and they can suck the air out, and then you're going to have warm, fresh air from outside being gently blown
in. Something like four times the amount of fresh air that you get in the building than a building regs compliant building.
One thing I do not understand is in a passive house, and what happens if you get a cat? Where does the cat flap go?
No cat flap allowed, no letterbox allowed.
Seriously?
Yeah, no letterbox, because it's a source of heat loss and air loss.